Okay, we know that DJ Rajiz is not around, but DJ Slam really got us on the music vibe. Make sure that you stay tuned. It's hashtag Hip Hop Thursday. My name is Michelle Ashera, and it's that time whereby we look into your text messages, and equally, wow, you guys have been so lively on social media. So we have a couple of, we have Karen from Karen Mbuthia. I was about to say Karen Kankang is here, texting session. But anyway, so Karen Mbuthia from Kitengela, she's saying that she's staying very much tuned and the show is very late. We have one, Mudhoni underscore Tracy, she says from all the way from Karatina, very much tuned in. Saying my show is very late and she loves whatever the DJ is doing on the decks. So make sure you stay tuned, Mudhoni. Then we have another one, Morgan, all the way from Nakuru. So guys, these messages are coming in. Remember, you can reach out to us at Y254 channel on our social media platform. That is on Facebook, Y254 underscore channel on Instagram. And DJ Slam, hey, you really got us on the wheel.
Lazima.
Nasi unaniambia on your sides, nimepata fan base.
Manze, kuna wase, lakini hili story nakuambia
baadaye. So in studio we have two amazing artists who have been signed by a label known as Afrocentric. And the names might not be, their faces might not be new to you because you've seen them a couple of on your screen, and if you follow them on your their social media handles, without further ado, I'll let them introduce themselves. So all the way from Caterpillar.
What's up, from Caterpillar. Member of Afrocentric. Afrocentric Group, by the way, is a label.
I thought it was a label because you guys, the project, like every time you release good music, it's like a team behind it.
Yeah, it's a team. Yes. So, since we are Red Tape Nation, our producer, Anito Tasla.
Okay.
So, he's the one who always handles the music, the videos, and everything.
Great, amazing job.
Yeah, I guess I'm similar to the mini top brand, Chumba. So I go by the name Chumba Afrocentric.
All right.
Yeah.
So you guys met...
We met in school, actually.
Okay, yeah. Take us back.
University, Rongo. Yeah, we met in the... Yo line ya, inetonga jo line ya admission hiyo, tulipatana hapo. And the first thing we talked, hip-hop.
Yeah, because those lines are usually kind of boring. So there's a long queue and you have to sign in some registration and everything.
So actually, tunakonga wanne. Now wili ya wako na sisi leo.
Yeah, I was asking about Hussein.
Some attachment things, shule ni. So tumekuja ku represent.
But we are so sure back at home people, you're going to represent them.
Yeah, kama kama.
Definitely.
Yes. So mkamita chuo, so how did the music come in now? Kabla hata tuonge kuhusu muziki, represent mta, mtuka mta gani?
Oh, mimi? Number 8, man, Kibera. A-Town.
A-Town.
Ya, mina tuka Migori, mazi. Aturusha Gimawe peke yake.
Narusha pia Mistari.
Mistari, yeah.
Okay, so all the way from Migori, Nairobi County, Nairobi. So music, ika come to adjust sasa?
Venye tu kama msanii, unezafanya, unandika andika, utuona msia kona interest, same na wewe, utuenda like kushare idea, so we share the idea. Kafana collab ya kwanza na huyu na Johnny. Johnny pia ni member wa crew. So we were like, manzesi, tuanze crew, tuwache ujinga. Ikakua group and we have been releasing music since then. Hiyo likuwa 2017, early 2017.
Actually, ni coincidence juu. Huyu Kata alipatana na Hassan kwa line. Yo day ya registration, yo day one. Walipatana kwa line, wakaanza kuongea story ya ngoma nini nini. Then mi nilireport chuo like later. But mi na Hassan tuko daro moja. So kukuja Dario Day, nikamcheki, tukaanza tukuvibe, tukaongea. Then Johnny, ya nakuwa vocalist wetu. Yes, aku, huyu na Johnny wako.
Pia kuwa atacho.
Ya, huyu na kuwa atacho. So ye, na Kata na Johnny wao wako town campus, alafu, mimi na Hassan tuko main. Sasa unacheki wao walijua na town, then, mimi na Hassan tukajua na mimi, then tukukuja tuku mix, juu tulikuwa tuna vibe.
Okay, what are you guys studying or what are you still studying? Are you guys done?
Yeah, mimi ni mwana siyasa manze, political science.
Hey!
Yomana na kungana yoke lele kwa rap.
Yomana pia unavumbua vumbua waju waki rada.
Mimi ni saw media.
Okay.
Ya nafanya graphics, communication and advertising. Yeah.
Okay, so you guys mkianza usani, you started off as a crew venye mko. Hakuna ti individual projects prior.
Actually, mm-hmm. kwa crew yetu kuna ile independence yenye unapatiwa kama msanii.
Mm-hmm.
So uki feel like ah, hii instrumental jo acheni tu nipige solo.
Mm-hmm.
Unaweza flex kama wewe we release. Yeah, so it's still the tukiwin mm-hmm. crew ina win. Even though sit na work.
Alafu pia ingine ni vibe, sio work na vibe tu. Unajua kila msanii anakoga na strength yake na weakness yake sindio? So kama msanii ako strength yake on something and ana feel yo ikitu nenda inaweza kuwa dope. So si anatag tu mse, though jina ni moja tu, Afrocentric.
Afrocentric.
Yeah.
So you guys, when you talk about hip-hop, yes? And there's an inclusion of Afro. Was it, how did the Afrocentric come by? The name of the...
By the way, yeah, si ati tunafanya, as in we, si tunapenda hip-hop, we were born for this. Lakini Afro, pia tunaweza unajua lazima pia to represent like the African culture kama Kenya. So we have songs that are not hip hop.
Sifanya Afro pop pia.
Yeah. Is about
because there's a time I've seen on your IG handle and there was a gig. It was in a kind of club setup and you were freestyling in an Afro beat.
True.
So I was like, okay, I would like to know if you are.
Hence the name Afro. So hizo ngoma ni mingi, ni album actually tunataka ku release na ma video. Sasa hivi tunafanya hip hop na nini. So the Afrocentric part hiyo watu watapata after hiyo album na ma video zenye tuna plans ki drop.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Okay, so apart from as a crew, what was your first project?
Mine.
As a crew?
No, as an individual. Oh, you guys have just because you talk about even as a crew na work with the supportive system, but at the end of the day, the label looks at your individual projects.
Sasa ndio tulianza officially 2017. But sasa prior umsa alikuwa zake nini, so mimi nilianza ku record audio yangu kwanza ni record 2015.
Mm-hmm.
But actually ni audio moja tu ndio nikakuja ku perform. Ilikuwa cultural leaks, no?
Yeah.
Ilikuwa cultural leak, nika perform.
Oh, cultural leak too?
Yeah.
Okay.
So hapo ndio actually huyu sasa hata nilionaga, then after hapo akipata, hey, bro, ni kusikia uko dope, nini? Yupi akanichapa wa freestyle kadhaa, yeah, ni waya. So nikasema, yo, tuneza meet to vibe tufanye kitu.
Okay.
Yeah.
So for you, when you're coming up with your lyrics, are there moments whereby una feel, I don't really, I don't address any issue in terms of your music. Do you shy off addressing personal issues?
This is hip hop. You don't shy off from facts.
Facts.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for that statement. Let's go back to because when I was introduced to you, it was during the Calicatel.
Yeah.
And Calligraph Jones. So, first of all, how did you link up with Cali?
Cali.
Yeah.
By the way, mimi nimekuwa nikitoa mangoma na ika YouTube, so constantly tagging him huko social media na nini.
Ndio hapo sasa, hii ndio leakage kwa wasanii nyumbani.
So nilikuwa namtaga IG hapo, namwambia venye nini, ana reply once in a while. So mimi nilikuwa nimedoze home siku fulani manzee, nikasikia anapigiwa. Kapara ni Jones. Yeah.
Okay, so on your line for kwa Calicatel, you mentioned like, let me see. Uko na machungu na Butros. Machungu ilitoka wapi?
Hiyo ni mambo ya last year.
Sawa, but we need to address this. Is the first time you are here on
people. Yeah, I know. Imagine hata wewe hauwezi penda kula beef yenye imelala. Beef iliisha last year, so
kwa hivyo there is no beef right now.
I don't know.
Hata iko beef anyway.
Because alikuwa dressed later on.
Yeah, and I addressed him too. So nilikaa nilifungwa hivyo tu, yani unaona.
So right now 2019 tumefunga 2018.
It's all about us music. Negative vibe mzee unabaki nayo huko.
Sawa basi. But what's your take on trap music?
Trap.
No take.
I don't know.
What's your take on trap music?
Nimekuwa niki vibe nayo siku hizi kiasi.
Mhm.
But I don't know. They are doing their thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh no, I think we're going to right now. No, it's we're not. Yeah. It's not here.
Oh, my take on trap music.
Yeah, I don't like talking about trap music because it's something like that young music. People are doing it.
Yeah, I don't like trap music. But yeah, anyone of anything yao, sisi pia tunafanya thing yetu.
So, but you don't like trap.
I don't.
You don't.
Yeah.
DJ Slam ako hapo just like supporting you very strongly. Why are you guys not on mbona mpindi?
Do you know the origin of this?
The original educators, please.
Of this equipment on music,
mm-hmm.
turntables,
mm-hmm.
it was meant to play hip hop.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
It was meant to play hip hop.
Yeah. So, okay, I'm also not a big fan of sharp music. You know, sometimes it's only that we are pressurized as DJs to play sharp, because some people might request it, you know, and it come out after door, we'll just have to do it.
Mm-hmm.
But, eish, 100%.
So you're supportive. Caterpillar.
Yeah.
So Caterpillar, as you continue, so these people have said they're not in support of sharp music. What's your take?
I don't support sharp music either.
It's not like we don't support.
Okay, it's not. It's not
like we don't support sharp.
It's not like support.
They are doing their thing. Kama vinyewe sub semi aje.
Yes. So sharp music.
You know, everybody vibes to different stuff, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Just the same way. Unasikizaga hizi marumba flani, hizi za...
Let me tell you, one thing that I've never understood about rumba, because I don't really understand the language, but people actually love rumba. If you talk about rumba music, or if that's...
Rumba actually...
Exactly.
People will turn up and have a good time.
So see, the same way.
I think the kind of people they will find in rumba events, right?
Yeah, rumba ni poa jukunase wanaimba na wana put food table through that, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So we got to respect that even. Lakini, saiki kuja kwa personal preference, I don't do shrap.
Okay, so different individuals with different, want to resonate with different aspects of craft when it comes to different genres of music. Okay, so you guys have released the new genre known as Icon. You've mentioned Abasco Bar, Steph Capella, Official Ecstatic, All the Way, Love of Petra, and Vera is anyway on the side. So do you guys see yourself as, at one point, you guys being iconic?
Yeah, God willing. Actually, I want to point out something. Hiyo ngoma si ati tunabusu haga manini.
No,
we are just trying to. Yeah, we are just trying to like.
Mention.
Tunawambia hata kama wao tulenga, though they still love from the underground and nini, unaona. Tunawa respect even wenye wako.
Umesema kitu muhimu hapo Caterpillar.
Yes, ndio. So bado wako fit, unaona.
Yeah,
so we are doing our thing pia sisi, unaona. Pia sisi siku moja tutafika huko. We are already there actually mahali tu hapo. Yeah.
Yeah, alafu hiyo concern ilikuja ile design. Sisi ni wa Kenya, si ndio? And we have to embrace Kenya like yo play KE. So unapata most rappers tukianza ku refer to like msemenya me make it in hip hop. Utapata msia anaongea kuhusu Tupac, anaongea kuhusu Biggie. Ana sawa majuu. Huku hivi tuko na kina Bass, tuko na Isa Kala Mashaka. So it's tunafaa ku embrace sisi kwanza, like tukue sisi, unaona. Juu actually kuna hip hop artists wengi hapa hivi chini, lakini hatuwasikizi. Mbona
underground
artists hatuwasikizi juu tuko more focused on
majuu
artists. So as a lyricist, what are the couple of things that you look at before you release your any of your music?
So
the basics that you have to look into, you say
the first ndio uandike ngoma. It depends with the vibe you had.
Okay.
And the instrumental, so hiyo vibe yako plus the instrumental definitely utatoa something kama wewe ni lyricist ukweli. Yeah, so ni vibe tu, then the rest is just magic. It will happen with the
kind of like a secret, nothing, it's just the vibe.
Practice ni muhimu.
Yeah,
constantly writing, constantly
pia kukua relevant.
How do you stay relevant?
Unangalia vitu kali.
Before you answer that, you've talked about ukwe relevant.
Uh-huh.
So how do you, for the people who are back at home and they're looking forward to get into music or in music, how do you become relevant, and how do you maintain the relevance?
Kitu kwanza unakuwa relevant kusikiza wasi wengine, that's one.
Mm-hmm.
Juu sisi wote ni ma-artist, ndio?
Mm-hmm.
And you can't be, uwezi kuwa island peke yako. Lazima usikie, yo, kali amongelele nini leo? Okay, what's trending? What am I supposed to address?
So you have to be updated.
Yeah, you have to be updated in literally everything.
Okay.
Yeah.
So speaking about staying relevant and being relevant, who are the couple of people that you listen to?
In Kenya.
That inspires your music, that makes you...
Me by then nasikiza underground music sana. So I'd put Wakadinali hapo. TNT, they're doing something nice. Kuna
Kamba Boy
mbithi, akina Steph Capella. Watu wanaoma sana.
Cool music.
Cool music, yeah.
Papa Jones, Octopizzo, Nyash. Yeah, hata Sauti Sol pia tunawasikizanga nini.
Susikizi kila mse, actually.
I love the fact that you've mentioned all Kenyan artists, and that's what Icon is all about. And we like DJ Slam.
Yeah.
You ready? They introduced this new song.
New jam.
But before that, I want to shout out one producer,
okay.
A very good friend of mine.
Sawa.
He does shrap. That's why.
I know you're trying to be right on the...
DJ Kazi, you're before to play.
Okay.
Your song, it's written and performed by Caterpillar and Hassan. So Hassan is Kuana Sileo. So we'll just step in, but it's all Afrocentric.
All right, Afrocentric in the building. So you introduce the song,
all
right. The genre, Iconic, and you give out your social Icon. Media handles. Icon.
Okay. Icon.
Yeah, the next track is Icon, mixed and mastered by Tasla on the beat. Red Tape Nation.
Red Tape Nation.
Performing artist Afrocentric. Hiyo ngoma inaongelelea manze, all the legends we have ever had. Kuna wengine sikutaja lakini, yeah, they are all like okay, tuwa categorize hapo tu manze, tunawapenda jo.
Msianze huu mbona mkutaja sijina.
Lakini wajua metambulika.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So social media handles and then you introduce the jam.
Oh, Afro, Instagram, it's Afro.